Anybody who's got one of these will feel my pain. Everything's fine till the day of its MOT. And now, ABS light. So, we're gonna have a look at fixing this fault. Now, this was fine the last time I drove it. The ABS light didn't come on or didn't present while I was driving. It was literally, I started it up and there it was. So hopefully that means that the reluctor ring or whatever it is, the pickup on that wheel bearing's fine. It's probably an electrical or I suspect a sensor problem. I haven't got one of them screen sharing software things. Sorry about this. And there may be some flickering when the sun comes out, but however, this isn't a VCDS tutorial. This is an ABS sensor thing. Let's have a look at that. So ignition on. And then we select control module. And then ABS sensor. And when that communicates, that will liven up. We're looking at fault codes. Check the fault codes. Two faults. Now, I did the start motor on this, so I had the battery off, on and off. So we'll clear that. Hang on. Check the second one first. ABS sensor, electrical fault in circuit. All right. Clear that. Yes. One fault, there we go. So that's the one with, that's the current fault code. The other one was this historic, just because it was a one-time thing where I had the battery off. Wheel speed sensor. So done, go back. Now, code reading is okay, but live data, measuring blocks, that's where the money is. So if we look at this one, we can see each individual wheel speed sensor. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to spin this rear right, and you should see, if I get out of the way, you should see that in normal circumstances, that read speed reading. So if I spin it, nothing. So what this tells us is the ECU isn't seeing a signal. What we're going to do is we're going to check voltage across these two terminals with the ignition on. Right, so see these little tiny connectors. I don't want to be stuffing these in there. So what I've done, a couple of bits of scrap wire, soldered the ends, hammered them, and then trimmed them down so they're really thin. And they should just fit in here and let me connect into these terminals. And then the other end is just bare. So we can get our crocodile clips, come with an altimeter, pop one on there. Then it fall down somewhere. Stop that from dropping, but here's the other one. Hang that over there, right, that's not gonna go anywhere. Now, if we move over to the multimeter, bear with me a second. I'm gonna do this in one go, so you see there's no smoke and mirrors. Right, volts, can you see that? Battery's seen better days on this, but anyway, I'm gonna go and switch the ignition on now. And that should switch from millivolts to somewhere around 11 and a half to 12 and a bit, but this battery's been sitting for, or the vehicle's been sitting, I've driven it. What have we got? 11.5. Right, so we've got voltage here, so that means the wiring's okay. So what we're looking at is very probably a simple just sensor. So let's get a new sensor, plug it in and see what it does. Right. Get this screw out, it's a 5mm Allen key. I'll give it a good soaking with all that forks again, Allen keys. Don't be frightened to give it a bit of a mur. And we'll tighten it up a little bit. Sometimes it just cracks off any rust, and if it moves, don't go mad because we don't want to strip it. And then, oh, beautiful. the advantage of soaking it. That's kind of the worst bit of ABS sensors, getting the actual screw out. The next challenge is getting the sensor out itself, because it's made of plastic. You can't give it a lot of... Oh, it's moving. Is that a good sign, or is that just a flip? There's nothing to lever against. I'm going to twist this if I can. Give this a little tap. So I'll knock that in there. Try and get something on the other side. This isn't wobbling about too much for you, but there's not much I can do about that, I'm afraid. I'm just putting another screwdriver in. So nice if I could actually see what I was doing. Screwdriver's moving, so it's a really good thing or a shocking mistake. It's not wiggling yet, but I'm just going to keep repeating that until it starts moving. So progress update, not a massive shock. The old sensor snapped, which made getting it out a lot more difficult. So I took the disc off. The idea of getting the back plate off to give me a bit more room, but these bolts are so rusty, I just don't want to get involved in that. So anyway, what I did was, where the sensor was in here, I chiseled the end off to give me a nice flat surface and then just drove it out with a punch that way. What I'm doing now is cleaning that hole, because there's an awful lot of rust in there. So I'll clean this out and then hopefully the new sensor will slide in and we'll be back in business. But it's not the quick one bolt, one connector job that I was hoping for. But let me carry on and clean this up. So there's our new sensor in. Get it plugged up, get the wheel on, clear the code, and then do some live data. So that little 5mm Allen key, just don't go mad when you're tightening it up. You're just holding it in place, not holding the weld together.
There we go, brilliant. So look at the measure of locks, group one.
I don't know if you can see, I'm trying to zoom in this there. You can see it's corroded because the tip actually broke off this.